हेलो स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी स्टार्ट वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग चैप्टर ऑफ क्लास 10th साइंस बायोलॉजी लाइफ प्रोसेसेस। इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू टेक ए ओवरव्यू ऑफ ऑल द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ लाइफ प्रोसेस चैप्टर। ओके, सो लेट वी स्टार्ट। व्हाट इज लाइफ प्रोसेस चैप्टर एंड व्हाट इज लाइफ? अर्थ हैपन्स टू बी द ओनली नॉन प्लेनेट हैविंग ए लाइफ। देर आर बींग हु लिव, डाई एंड बिकम पार्ट ऑफ नेचर अगेन। द लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म कैन बी डिफ्रेंशिएटेड फ्रॉम द इनएनिमेट इंटेंटिटीज ऑन वेरियस पैरामीटर ऑफ लाइफ प्रोसेसेस। लाइफ प्रोसेसेस मेंटेनेंस ऑफ लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म इज एसेंशियल इवन इफ दे आर मूविंग, रेस्टिंग और इवन स्लीपिंग। द प्रोसेसेस विच टूगेदर परफॉर्म द फंक्शन ऑफ मेंटेनेंस ऑफ लाइफ आर कॉल्ड एज लाइफ प्रोसेसेस। न्यूट्रिशन, रेस्पिरेशन, सर्कुलेशन, एक्सक्रीशन आर एग्जाम्पल ऑफ एसेंशियल लाइफ प्रोसेसेस। इन यूनिसेलुलर ऑर्गेनिज्म ऑल दीज प्रोसेसेस आर कैरिड आउट बाय सिंगल सेल, फॉर एग्जाम्पल अमीबा। इन मल्टी सेलुलर ऑर्गेनिज्म वेल डेवलप्ड सिस्टम आर प्रेजेंट टू कैरी आउट द प्रोसेसेस। ओके स्टूडेंट, सो इन दिस चैप्टर फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी स्टार्ट न्यूट्रिशन। व्हाट इज न्यूट्रिशन एंड द टाइप ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन? न्यूट्रिशन इन प्लांट एंड न्यूट्रिशन इन एनिमल। सो लेट वी स्टार्ट न्यूट्रिशन। वी ऑलरेडी हैव नो अबाउट लिविंग एंड नॉन लिविंग थिंग्स। ऑल लिविंग थिंग्स परफॉर्म सर्टेन लाइफ प्रोसेसेस लाइक ग्रोथ, एक्सक्रीशन, रेस्पिरेशन, सर्कुलेशन एटसेट्रा। एनिमल्स, बर्ड्स एंड ह्यूमन बींग आर लिविंग बींग। दीज फॉल एस्लिप इन द नाइट और डे। We see them breathing, so we know that they are alive. Some animal can breathe without visible movement, so using visible movements as the defining characteristic of life is not enough. The plants, they grow over time. We tend to think of some sort of movement, either growth related or not. But a plant that is not visibly growing is still alive. The invisible molecular movement is necessary for life because all the structures are made up of molecules. They must move molecules around all the time. Therefore, let's define what life process. Here is all the processes like respiration, digestion, which together keep the living organism alive and perform the job of body maintenance are called life processes. Okay, first of all, when we start this video, then I told you what is life processes. Now we discuss about mode of nutrition. There are two type of mode of nutrition. First is autotrophic type of mode of nutrition and second one is heterotrophic type of mode of nutrition. In autotrophic mode of nutrition, the organism make their own food. For example, plants, they are autotrophic in nature. And in heterotrophic nutrition, the organisms are depend on other organism for their feeding. The heterotrophic nutrition are further divided into three category. First one is holozoic nutrition, second one is saprophytic nutrition, and third one is parasitic nutrition. So now we discuss nutrition in plants. Nutrition in plants. Plants are autotrophs. Okay, plants are autotrophs because they make their own food, eat animals for their food. Nutrition in animals are heterotrophs, depend on other organism for their feeding. What is autotrophic nutrition? It is a kind of nutrition in which inorganic material like carbon dioxide, water, etc. are utilized to prepare organic food by the process of photosynthesis. By the process of photosynthesis, for example, green plants. Autotrophs use simple inorganic material and convert it into complex high energy molecules, carbohydrate. Okay, it is a simple reaction. Carbon dioxide when react with water. Okay, simple substances, inorganic substances now convert into C6H12O6. ग्लूकोज, इट इज़ अ कार्बोहाइड्रेट, ओके, इन कॉम्प्लेक्स इनऑर्गेनिक सब्सटेंसेस. सो दिस प्रोसेस इज नोन एज फोटोसिंथेसिस. ऑटोट्रॉपिक न्यूट्रिशन इज फुलफिल्ड बाय द प्रोसेस बाय विच ऑटोट्रॉप्स टेक इन CO2 एंड H2O एंड कन्वर्ट दीज इनटू कार्बोहाइड्रेट इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ क्लोरोफिल. सनलाइट इज कॉल्ड फोटोसिंथेसिस. ओके, द रिएक्शन ऑफ फोटोसिंथेसिस इज लाइक दिस. 6 CO2 कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड, 12 H2O इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ सनलाइट. In the presence of sunlight, in the presence of chlorophyll, and in the presence of some ions, they are converted into C6H12O6 glucose or carbohydrate. This process is known as photosynthesis. By the photosynthesis, the plants make their own food. Raw materials for photosynthesis are sunlight, chlorophyll, carbon dioxide and water. Main events of photosynthesis, first is absorption of light energy by chlorophyll. First of all, chlorophyll absorb the sunlight. Conversion of light energy into chemical energy. Now light energy is converted into chemical energy. Reduction of carbon dioxide to carbohydrate. Okay, the first event is, first of all, the chlorophyll molecule absorb the sunlight. Second one is light energy convert into chemical energy and reduction of CO2 to carbohydrate. Now we discuss about one structure which is present on the leaf and sometime it is also present on the green plant stem. They are known as stomata. Stomata are responsible for the gaseous exchange in the plant. Now we discuss about what is stomata. Stomata are the tiny pores present on the surface of the leaves. Exchange of gases like O2 and CO2. The function of stomata, the two main functions of stomata are to allow for the uptake of carbon dioxide and to limit the loss water due to evaporation. Evaporation means the loss of water in the vapor form is known as evaporation. It is also known as transpiration. Heterotrophic nutrition. Now we discuss about heterotrophic nutrition. Kind of nutrition in which organism does not possess the ability to synthesize their own food. It depends on the autotrophs for their food supply directly or indirectly. For example, animals, we are the autotrophs, heterotrophs, and fungi. Heterotrophic nutrition is further divided into three categories: holozoic nutrition, saprophytic nutrition, and parasitic nutrition. In holozoic nutrition, a complex digestive system is present, digestion mechanism is present. In saprophytic nutrition, the organism which depend on dead and decaying matter, okay, so they are known as saprophytes. Okay, the nutrition is known as saprophytic nutrition. And parasitic nutrition, some organisms are survive on other organism outside the body or inside the body for their feeding, and they also harm the other organism also. So this kind of nutrition is known as parasitic nutrition. For example, ticks, cuscuta is a plant, okay, plant parasite. Now we discuss how organism obtained their food. Unicellular single-celled organism food is taken up through entire surface. For example, amoeba. Amoeba, first of all, amoeba form the pseudopodia. By the help of these pseudopodia, the amoeba catch the food particles and transfer these food particles into the body and form a food vacuole. In this food vacuole, the enzymes are come from the cytoplasm and digestion mechanism is occur. After digestion complete, the food vacuole is disappear and the waste materials are thrown outside the body. It is the types of holozoic nutrition in amoeba. Now we discuss about nutrition in human being. Nutrition in human being. The alimentary canal is basically a long tube extending from the mouth to the anus. Various regions are specialized to perform different function. Okay, in human digestive system is divided into two parts: digestive system or digestive tract or alimentary canal and digestive gland. Digestive tract or alimentary canal having mouth, oral cavity or buccal cavity, pharynx, esophagus, stomach, small intestine and large intestine and anus. Small intestine further divided into three parts: duodenum, jejunum and ileum, and large intestine further divided into cecum, colon and rectum. Rectum open into the anus. And many digestive glands are also present in the human body. They are responsible for the secretion of some substances or some enzymes which are helpful in the digestion of the food. For example, salivary gland. In our mouth, three types of salivary glands are present: parotid gland, submaxillary gland, sublingual gland. Sublingual gland and submaxillary gland or submandibular glands are present below the tongue, and parotid gland is present below the ear. Okay. So the parotid gland secrete saliva. In this saliva, salivary amylase enzyme is present. This salivary amylase enzyme convert starch into the sugar or maltose. Okay. So the first digestion is start in our mouth cavity or buccal cavity, and second digestive gland is gastric gland, which is situated in the stomach. The gastric gland secrete gastric juice. In this gastric juice, many protein digested enzymes are also present. Gastric gland also secrete HCl. Some parietal cells are present in the gastric gland. They secrete HCl, hydrochloric acid. This hydrochloric acid kill the bacteria which are enter in our stomach. Okay, so they kill the bacteria, and HCl provide the acidic medium to the stomach. And third digestive gland is pancreas. Pancreas is also known as mixed gland because it perform endocrine nature and exocrine function also. Okay, it also secretes some enzyme which are very helpful in the digestive mechanism. And next gland is liver. Okay, largest gland of the body is known as liver. Liver secrete bile juice. In this bile juice, there is no digestive enzyme present. This bile juice is secreted by liver, but it is stored in the gallbladder. It is stored in the gallbladder. When requirement, this bile juice is come into the small intestine by the help of hepatic duct. Hepatic duct is open into the common duct. Common duct is also associated with pancreas. Common duct open into the small intestine, duodenum region. So all the juices are come into the small intestine: gastric juice, pancreatic juice and bile juice. So the large part of the food digestion is present in the small intestine. Okay. The alimentary canal is basically a long tube extend from the mouth to the anus. Various regions are specialized to perform different function: mouth, teeth, tongue, salivary gland, esophagus, stomach, small intestine. Wall of small intestine secrete intestinal enzymes which convert carbohydrate into glucose or fatty acid and glycerol, and protein into amino acid. Okay, carbohydrate, when we take the food in, the food is the form of polysaccharide. Carbohydrate in the form of polysaccharide. Now these polysaccharide are convert into monosaccharides. Okay, like glucose, galactose, etc. And amino acid are convert into protein are convert into amino acid, and fat is convert into glycerol and fatty acid. It receives the secretion of the liver and pancreas. The food is acidic, which is made up alkaline for the pancreatic enzyme to act. The pancreas secrete pancreatic juice, which contain enzyme like trypsin for digesting proteins and lipase breaking down emulsified fat. The emulsification of fat is occur in liver. बिकॉज इन लीवर बाइल जूस इज सिक्रेटेड, दिस बाइल जूस इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द इमल्सिफिकेशन ऑफ द फैट. नाउ दिस इमल्सिफाइड फैट इज ब्रेकिंग डाउन बाय द हेल्प ऑफ विच एंजाइम? लाइपेज एंजाइम. फैट आर प्रेजेंट इन द इंटेस्टाइन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ लार्ज ग्लोब्यूल्स विच मेक्स इट डिफिकल्ट फॉर एंजाइम टू एक्ट ऑन दैम. बाइल सॉल्ट्स ब्रेक दैम डाउन इन टू स्मॉलर ग्लोब्यूल विच इंक्रीज द एफिशियंसी एंजाइम एक्शन. लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन एब्जॉर्ब एक्सेस ऑफ वाटर. द रेस्ट ऑफ द मटीरियल इज रिमूव फ्रॉम द बॉडी वाया द एनस. ओके, सो दिस इज द डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम ऑफ ह्यूमन बींग. नाउ वी मूव ऑन रेस्पिरेशन इन ह्यूमन बींग. रेस्पिरेशन इन ह्यूमन बींग. इट इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ गैस एक्सचेंज बिटवीन द एयर एंड एन ऑर्गेनिज्म सेल्स. ब्रेकडाउन ऑफ ग्लूकोज बाई वेरियस पाथवे. इट इज अ जस्ट अपोजिट टू द फोटोसिंथेसिस. ओके, वट इज रेस्पिरेशन? द कॉम्प्लेक्स ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड आर ब्रेक डाउन इन टू सिंपलर ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड. इट इज नोन एज रेस्पिरेशन. नाउ वी डिस्कस अबाउट टाइप्स ऑफ रेस्पिरेशन. देर आर थ्री टाइप ऑफ रेस्पिरेशन: इंटरनल, एक्सटर्नल एंड सेलुलर. इंटरनल रेस्पिरेशन इन्वॉल्व्स गैस एक्सचेंज between the blood and body cell. External respiration is the breathing process which involves inhalation and exhalation of gases. And cellular respiration involves the conversion of food to energy. Now we discuss respiration in human being. Respiration involves gaseous exchange breathing. Breathing is a part of respiration. No, it is not a respiration, it is a part of respiration. Intake of oxygen from the atmosphere and release carbon dioxide is known as breathing. Cellular respiration: breakdown of simple food in order to release energy inside the cell. Okay, so what is the breathing and what is the respiratory system in human body? In our in human being, one pair of nostril is present. Okay, nostrils are open in nasal cavity. Nasal cavity open into the nasopharynx and nasopharynx open into the pharynx. Okay, pharynx further divided into two branches. First is windpipe, second is known as food pipe. Windpipe open into the trachea. On the trachea, one larynx is present. It is also known as sound box or voice box. Okay, now trachea is further divided into two branches. They are known as bronchus or bronchi. Each bronchus enter into the lungs. Okay, right lung and right lungs, right and left lungs. Okay, the bronchus when enter into the lungs, it is further divided into primary bronchi and tertiary bronchi. Tertiary bronchi further divided into two branches. They are known as bronchioles, and bronchioles are further divided and they are open into alveoli sac. Okay, alveoli are covered by many capillaries. Okay, when we inhale oxygen, now this oxygen is come into the alveoli sac to capillaries to the tissue, and tissue to the cell. In the cell, cellular respiration is occur. Okay, in the presence of oxygen, aerobic respiration is occur. Now complex organic compounds are break down into simpler organic compound. Okay student, breakdown of glucose by various pathway. The first step is the breakdown of glucose, a 6-carbon molecule, into 3-carbon molecule called pyruvate, which take place in the cytoplasm, and the phenomena is called as glycolysis. Okay, it is occur in the cytoplasm. The pyruvate may be converted into ethanol and carbon dioxide, which takes place in yeast during fermentation. Since this process takes place in the absence of air or oxygen, it is called anaerobic respiration. The pyruvate is broken down into 3-carbon pyruvate molecule in the presence of oxygen to give 3 molecules of carbon dioxide and water. This process takes place in mitochondria. The aerobic respiration is occur in the mitochondria. What is aerobic respiration? In the presence of oxygen, the respiration is known as aerobic respiration. Since this process takes place in the presence of air oxygen, it is called aerobic respiration. The pyruvate is converted into lactic acid when there is a lack of oxygen in our muscle cell, is also a 3-carbon molecule. This buildup of lactic acid in our muscles during sudden activities causes cramps. Okay, in bone cramps or muscle cramps. The energy released during cellular respiration is immediately used to synthesize a molecule called ATP, which is used to fuel all other activities in the cell. In these processes, ATP is broken down, giving rise to a fixed amount of energy. What is ATP? ATP is also known as energy currency of the cell, adenosine triphosphate, which can drive the endothermic reaction take place in the cell. The rate of breathing in aquatic organism is much faster than that seen in terrestrial organism because the amount of dissolved oxygen is fairly low compared to the amount of oxygen in the air. Okay, now we discuss human respiratory system. We discuss before this human respiratory system, we draw the diagram. Human respiratory system, nostril open into nasal cavity open into pharynx open into two branches, food pipe and windpipe open into two lungs. Okay, these are two lungs, these are known as bronchus. They are come into the lungs. In lungs, they are further divided into primary, secondary and tertiary bronchi. Bronchi open into bronchus and bronchus open into alveoli. Okay, so the parts of human respiratory systems are nostril. Air is taken into the body, nasal passages or nasal passage. It is channel for air flow through the nose, nasal cavity. It is lined with hairs and mucous membrane. It warms, moisturizes and filters air before it reaches the lungs. Pharynx. It contains rings of cartilage which ensure that the air passage does not collapse. Okay. Larynx. It houses the vocal cords and manipulates pitch and volumes, which is essential for phonation. It is also known as voice box. Trachea. Pharynx split into trachea and esophagus. It connects the larynx or voice box to the bronchi of the lungs. It provides airflow to and from the lungs for respiration. Bronchi. They are the main passageway into the lungs. They are the extension of the windpipe that settle air to and form the lungs. The oxygen gas to the lungs and carbon dioxide leave the lungs through them. Now we discuss bronchioles. Bronchi gets smaller when they reaches closer to lungs tissue and are called bronchioles. They are the passageway by which air passes through the nose or mouth to the alveoli of the lungs. Alveoli. They are smaller tubes which finally terminate in balloon-like structure which are called alveoli. They allow oxygen and carbon dioxide to move between the lungs and bloodstream, blood capillaries. They are the site of the transfer of oxygen and other nutrients from the bloodstream to other tissues in the body. They also collect carbon dioxide and waste material and return it to the vein. Now we discuss respiration in plant. In plant, there is no specific organ is present, only gaseous exchange is present. So now we discuss respiration in plant. Respiration in plant is similar than the respiration in animal. Gaseous exchange occur through stomata in leaves. We study what is stomata. Lenticle in stems. Lenticles are present in the stem and general surface of the root. Okay, so now we discuss in this chapter, we discuss two life processes. First is nutrition, human digestive system, and respiration in plant and animal. Next video, we discuss about transportation in human being. So thank you, student.